Today in America, 90% of our people live and work on 2% of our land. Our cities are becoming inhumane. Our rural areas depressed. In North Carolina, in Warren County, we're making a fresh start at Soul City. We have 3,500 acres of beautiful land with more than 400 acres set aside for industrial development. An initial 100-acre tract has been fully developed. The terrain is level and soils are well drained with a sanded to clay loam surface over firm red clay. The most prominent soil type is the Cecil Association with small portions of Appling Association. Both are more than adequate for industrial construction. Parcels range from 5 to 50 acres or more. Access roads are in, as are water, sewer, and underground electrical utilities. Undeveloped land is also available at Soul City. Soul City is located in the Piedmont Industrial Corridor and positioned to serve a second big market, the Northeast Megalopolis. Soul City's 500-mile market area encompasses 13 states, 68 major metropolitan areas, and one-third of the United States population. Shippers can reach most major markets in the east overnight. I-95 runs about 35 miles east of Soul City. I-85 runs within a mile of Soul City and connects with I-40 about an hour south. Regular carriers serve Soul City in both intrastate and interstate schedules. A major railroad, Seaboard Coast Line, runs through Soul City. The Southern Railway is only 10 miles away, providing direct access to many major industrial and consumer markets. The Raleigh-Durham Airport offers interconnecting freight and passenger flights to every major city in America. Executive aircraft are served by the Henderson-Oxford Airport, only 15 miles away. For export activities, there are three deep water ports within 160 miles of Soul City: Norfolk, Morehead City, and Wilmington, all with container and bulk cargo facilities. Within a 25-mile radius, there is a recruitable workforce of over 4,600 people. Unemployment in Warren County during 1976 was over 9%. A significant number of people are underemployed. There are over 1,000 out commuters and the same number of high school and community college graduates a year. North Carolina's average manufacturing wage is much below the national average. And the average in Warren County's recruiting area is even lower. Very little work time is lost in North Carolina because of strikes. It's a right-to-work state, and only 8% of the non-agricultural workers belong to unions, the lowest in the country. North Carolinians want to work and are willing to go to school for necessary training. Last year, over 500,000 North Carolinians attended community colleges and technical institutes. Their average age was 29. Vance Granville Community College is near Soul City and will soon expand with a $1.5 million grant. The school will tailor special programs to meet the needs of industries locating at Soul City. Within a 100-mile radius of Soul City, there are 62 colleges, universities, and technical institutes. In North Carolina, you'll also find a favorable tax structure. Corporate taxes are fair in relationship to services rendered. Deficit spending is prohibited by the state constitution, and the basic tax structure in the state hasn't changed since 1935. Another thing you can count on at Soul City is a vast water supply. Carr Lake is only 6 miles from Soul City, and it feeds the $13 million Carr Lake Regional Water System at Soul City. The system's current capacity is 10 million gallons per day and has a holding capacity of 3 million gallons a day. Additional raw water is available from a source at Soul City. Water costs are competitive with other industrial sites in the southeast. Sewage will be pre-treated in aeration basins at Soul City, then piped through a 2 million gallon per day force main for treatment in Warrenton, 8 miles away. Electricity is supplied by Carolina Power and Light Company. The company's present capacity is 5,365,000 kilowatts, with an additional 5,962,000 kilowatts under construction. Total electric plant value is in excess of $1,956,000,000. CP&L also has a nuclear plant in Southport, North Carolina. Telecommunication is being provided by Carolina Telephone, a subsidiary of United Telephone. The Soul City Company and the two telephone companies are forming a task force to provide a worldwide telecommunication network for a rural area equal to any network in the Bell system. This system would be a big asset to a foreign trade zone, which we plan to have soon. Back at home, industries have already come to Soul City, and they're operating in the 73,000 square foot Soul Tech 1. Industries coming to Soul City will find a multidisciplinary team to provide technical help in many areas: construction, planning, financing, marketing, and legal. All types of housing are now available at Soul City. There are 5 builders on site, model homes for you to see. Prices for single-family detached homes start at $25,000 and go to $70,000. Townhouses will start at $20,000. VA, FHA, FMHA, and conventional financing can easily be arranged. Fire protection is provided by the Warren County Volunteer Fire Department. Law enforcement by the Warren County Sheriff's Office. Security guards are on site. You'll find excellent medical and dental care at HealthCo, located at Soul City. Within 15 minutes of Soul City, there are 2 high schools, 2 junior highs, 5 elementary schools, and 1 private school, grades K through 12. Libraries, golf courses, and other cultural and recreational facilities are also available in Warren County. Carr Lake, with 800 miles of shoreline, is only 6 miles from Soul City. Lake Gaston, 12 miles away. There's plenty to enjoy at Soul City, too. We have tennis courts, basketball courts, a swimming pool, 2 lakes, parks, and wilderness. There are lots of ways to enjoy yourself at Soul City. Altogether, Soul City offers broad opportunities for industry. As we pointed out, among Soul City's industrial advantages are an abundance of land with well-prepared infrastructure, a strategic market location with a third of the nation's population within 500 miles, transportation linkage with highways, rails, air, and deep water ports, excellent labor resources and schools for industrial training, a favorable tax structure, vast water resources and utilities at favorable rates, a high level of in-house technical assistance, and a quality environment. Because before we dug our first ditch or laid our first brick at Soul City, we laid plans for a freestanding city of 40,000 people. A city with the cultural and job opportunities of an urban environment, and at the same time, the living advantages of a rural environment. At Soul City, people of all ages, races, and religions can work together, play together, and learn together. Soul City, a fresh start.